let's look at the recovery operation. At least three persons are required for this operation. Accidents involving lifeboats often take place during recovery. Of these accidents, 70% are due to improper resetting of the release gear. As such, mastering the proper way to reset the release gear is extremely important. Properly resetting the release hook is an essential part of every recovery operation. Improper resetting may lead to the lifeboat being held by only one hook or even falling, resulting in a fatal accident. There are various types of release hooks. Regardless of type, improper resetting is indicated when the safety pin cannot be smoothly inserted or when extra force is required to return the release handle to the set position. If you have any doubts about the resetting operation, start over and redo each step in the process. To reset the release hooks, begin by pulling the release handle upward for about 30 degrees. Next, simultaneously lift the fore and aft hooks. After ensuring that the hooks have been reset properly, insert the safety pin. Finally, reset the safety lock device and make sure that it is in the locked position. The safety pin cannot be inserted unless the release handle is in its locked position. The reset procedure is the same no matter which type of release hook you are dealing with. Lift up both the fore and aft hooks and swing down the release hook reset levers. The release handle is automatically reset. Confirm that the release handle is fully reset and insert the safety pin. Next, insert the winch handbrake safety pin. Maneuver the lifeboat until it is under the boat falls. Using the winch, adjust the suspension links to the proper height. Simultaneously connect the suspension links to both the fore and aft hooks. Operate the winch using a remote controller and begin hoisting. Stop hoisting the lifeboat when it is just clear of the water and confirm that the fore and aft hooks are properly connected. Also confirm that the hydrostatic interlock lever has been moved back to the locked position. Resume hoisting. When the davit arm approaches the stowed position, the davit arm strikes the limit switch and the boat winch stops automatically. Only after it has been confirmed that the winch has stopped completely may the crew disembark the lifeboat. Place two persons on the davit platform to oversee proper stowage. When the winch stops automatically, manually hoist the davit arm. Confirm that the davit arm is in contact with the platform stop and cease winding. Beware of overwinding. Do not forget to detach the manual hoisting handle once winding has been completed. Immediately reset the davit arm stop and insert the safety pin in the davit arm stop handle. After removing the handbrake safety pin, lower the suspension blocks on the davit horn by releasing the handbrake. If the suspension blocks are not on the davit horn, the boat falls will remain under tension and may be damaged. Insert the handbrake safety pin. Be sure to turn the end of the safety pin. Install the auto trigger wire rope and use turnbuckles to tighten it. Install and tighten the overlashing wire rope. The painter should be kept attached to the painter release hook at all times.